Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. In this video, we are going to make a recipe of chocolate paan. These days, this chocolate paan is very popular. Today, we are going to make it in a homely style with some chocolate inside as well as outside. It's going to be crispy, juicy, mouth freshening of course, and very tasty. Perfect for everyone, including kids. So let's begin. For the chocolate paan, here I have the panwadi setup for making meetha paans. The key ingredient for making paan will remain paan leaves, whether the flavor is chocolate or green tea. I smuggled some Kolkata sweet paan leaves here. The issue with leaves is that they are never of the same size. So what we will do is we will trim the paan leaves of the size of your palm. Since we are making paan today with the whole leaf, we will first trim the bottom of the paan. You just have to cut the bottom of the paan leaf, basically cut the stem of the paan leaf, and then trim the sides of the paan using a scissor to the size of your hand. So here I'm just using my palm as a guide and I'm following the shape of the paan. After trimming the paans, they are ready to make paan. Before we begin assembling, we will first place some trimmings of the paan leaves on top of the paan leaves because otherwise the paan will break while shaping. So to stick that, here I'm using some hazelnut paste. That is because we are making chocolate paan right now. If you have some katha paste, then just dab it on top of the paan leaf and then place the trimmings on top. This will just ensure that the paan does not break while shaping it. Now since this is a chocolate paan and everyone loves chocolate including kids, so our katha today will be hazelnut paste or Nutella. This will provide an awesome flavor. You can also use some katha and limestone or chuna. Katha is also known as cashew in English. Here I'm just using about half a teaspoon of hazelnut paste for each paan. On top of the hazelnut paste, for authentic paan flavor, we will have to add some mouth fresheners. I found this Heera Panna mouth freshener. This is made with vegetables and fruits and it has a menthol type flavor. This is what is used by a few paan shops. You can just ask them and they will sell it to you. I'm just adding a little bit on top of each paan. Remember guys, a little bit goes a long way. Now all you have to do is spread the hazelnut paste and the mouth freshener really well. You can also add a little bit of peppermint here and then spread it. I'm going to add it later. That looks absolutely perfect to me, just like a paan stall. Next we will add some tutti frutti into this. I'm first adding green tutti frutti, then one piece of glazed Karonda or cherry, and then we will repeat with the red tutti frutti. I'm just adding color here guys, adding two colors of tutti frutti is totally optional. You guys know really well that coconut and chocolate goes really well and especially in paan, it's amazing. So here I'm adding a little bit of desiccated coconut to each paan. About 1/4 teaspoon to half a teaspoon should be good. So I did not have thinner variety of Saunf at home right now, that is the reason I'm using the thicker variety. You can also use the Mukhwas Saunf in this. About 1/4 teaspoon of Saunf into each paan and then we are going to add a little bit of choco chips. Crunchy biteable chocolate will be amazing in a paan, trust me. Next I am going to add a little bit of sugar confetti. Basically if you can find some Mukhwas then you can add it. See guys, the thing is, this is my 27th paan that I am making right now. I almost don't have any knowledge about it. I learned making paans by eating a few in a week and then I learned shaping them by destroying 12 paans. So I have a very little knowledge about it. I'm just adding some ingredients to it and then making it. A little bit of peppermint here is going to be really amazing. That's what I'm adding here, but be very careful. Pure peppermint is very strong, almost bitter in large quantities. And it is very expensive as well. You can also add a little bit of peppermint flavored candies like Polo. The main ingredient is Gulkand guys or rose petal jam. Without this, a paan does not taste like a paan. So here I am adding about 1 teaspoon of Gulkand into each paan. Also guys, try to avoid the watery Gulkand. Try to use the solid parts. Especially for making chocolate paans because we are going to coat it into chocolate. Now before we fold the paans, you have to prepare and keep some cloves and karondas handy. Here I have about 10 to 12 cloves ready for me to use, and I have some karondas pierced into toothpicks. We will use these both to shape and seal the paans. Now to begin folding it, you just have to take the paan in your palm, take hold of one side, the triangle side that is, fold it in, overlap the other side, and then pack the filling inside. You have to hold the paan really tight, guys, and then if you feel that it is very sticky and it won't fold really well, what you can do is you can add a little bit of desiccated coconut here. This will make it dry. Then you can fold it inwards and then seal it. When making the paans, if you are feeling that the paan can open up from a particular side, what you can do is just use a clove or a long and then press it inside. That will keep it shut, guys. Don't worry about it. At the end, just use a toothpick with a karonda and then place it inside. Similarly, I will make the remaining paans. For you also, once you make a few, it will be super easy. The paans are done, but these are regular paans right now. We will also prepare some dark chocolate. Here I am using about 200 grams of dark compound chocolate for coating the paans. Just place it in a bowl on top of a saucepan with some simmering water, stir it regularly, and you will have your chocolate melted. Next, what I'm doing is I'm coating two plates with aluminium foil so that we can set the chocolate in these plates. Pan is ready, chocolate is ready, plates are ready. Now let's get them to swim. This one was in too much of a hurry. Be careful, guys, just coat the paans and not the karonda and then place it in the plate. I have coated all the paans and they are looking good. Now I'm going to keep them in the fridge for about 5 minutes before serving. If you want to make these paans beforehand, you can absolutely do that. These paans will stay good in the refrigerator for up to 24 hours. Just keep them covered with a damp cloth. The paans are done. Before serving, I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of desiccated coconut, and the paans are ready to bite, chew and gulp. If you are making these paans for a party, then you can absolutely make it before. Keep it covered in the refrigerator and serve it by 2 or 3 days, but nothing like eating some fresh paan. Do try it. I'm sure you are going to love this one. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon with one more delicious recipe. Until next time, make sure to click the subscribe button and ring the bell icon beside it so that you get notified about my next video. Bye bye. Take care. Happy cooking.